Greetings. I have a burning question, and I hope that you can give me a logical answer, brother. Brother, you have told me that the Quran is eternal. And that sounds reasonable, doesn't it? Christians believe Jesus is eternal, and Jesus is called the Word of God. John 1:14, and the Word was made flesh and dwelt among us, and we beheld his glory, the glory as of the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and truth. So we believe the Word of God is eternal as well. Well, brother, here is the question that is bothering me. Which Quran is eternal? I know, you've said there is only one Quran. But the Quran says the Quran has been changed. Surah 2:106. None of our revelations do we abrogate or cause to be forgotten, but we substitute something better or similar. Knowest thou not that Allah has power over all things? Let's think about that with a picture. Let's first draw a picture of the original Quran. So here is the original Quran, 116 surahs. It had some number of surahs, we don't know. Remember, this original Quran is supposed to be eternal. The first question, brother, is did Allah abrogate the Quran before or after it became eternal? See, brother, this is where the fable of the eternal Quran runs into problems. Is it the concept of the Quran that is eternal, or is it the contents of the Quran that are eternal? If you go with the story that Allah created the Quran in perfect form originally, the concept of abrogation refutes this. If Allah changed it, it was not perfect to begin with. Remember what the Quran says. None of our revelations do we abrogate or cause to be forgotten, but we substitute something better or similar. We substitute with something better or similar. So here is the original Quran again, and here is the Quran after Allah improves Surah 45 and 100. Is this version of the Quran the eternal Quran? This version did not exist until Surah 45 and 100 were fixed, improved, abrogated. What about this older version of the Quran? Is it to be considered the original eternal Quran with the old Surah 45 and old Surah 100? And after another few billion years, Surah 68, 69, and 70 get abrogated? This is now the third version of the eternal, unchangeable Quran. Is this new version now the eternal Quran? After all, it has the fixes and corrections and substitutions for Surahs 45 and 100 and 68, 69, and 70. But this is only looking at the editing of the Quran to fix the original mistakes that Allah made. You see the confusion, brother. All this editing means the first Quran had mistakes and was less than perfect. The inclusion of the abrogation surah itself is troublesome, brother. It really means that even now, the Quran is not in some final form. If the Quran was perfect and was never going to change again, the abrogation surah should have been the final thing removed before publishing. None of our revelations do we abrogate or cause to be forgotten, but we substitute something better or similar. Notice this says none of our revelations. Something is not a revelation until it has been revealed. This can only be talking of changes made to existing revelations, already published and memorized Quran segments. Again, this creates a troubling problem for the eternal Quran, brother. Which Quran is considered the eternal, unchangeable Quran? Every abrogation creates a changed Quran. Every abrogation creates a different Quran. Every abrogation creates a new Quran. A new version that has never existed before. And if it never existed before, it is not eternal. Can you understand the logical problem the Quran has created for itself, brother? If anything in the Quran has changed, even with something better or at least similar, it is a new Quran. And a new Quran means it did not exist in eternity past. So which Quran is eternal? Clearly, with each change, the old version is forgotten or lost. None of our revelations do we abrogate or cause to be forgotten, but we substitute something better or similar. Notice this says cause to be forgotten. If this happens, you will have no memory it ever existed. Why, brother? Would Allah even bother to tell you? You see, brother, if Allah could make you forget, you would have no recall that you had forgotten. Allah would have no need to even tell you that He was switching out His version of the scripture. But if a man were changing his story over time, and you did remember the old and notice the change, such a man who could not make you forget would have to invent such a story. A religion created by a man would have to have a concept and doctrine of abrogation. So, which Quran is eternal? Let me know, my Muslim brother, if you can say. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.